I think teenagers are my favorite to work with because they're defining who they are. And they're not entirely sure who they are, but they're trying on things for size. And it's a good time in which to start empowering them on how to use their voice. And then other group of people I work with are adults who come for self-care. So they're coming from work or after a long day of work or even before work. I have a woman who's the president of her company. She comes before she goes to work just to get connected to her body. And she's definitely a born singer. And then I have a lot of young people who come wanting to become singers and go to McGill and, you know, U of T for opera. And those are fun because, you know, you're introducing them to opera and they're serious. My adults are usually coming for self-care. And they're equally, if not more, focused because they are so busy to make the time to sing. It means something to them, right? One was a breast cancer survivor and was in the early stages of Parkinson's. So singing for her was about staying flexible and fluid in her body and reconnecting to her voice that she once had. She came in, she'd lost 2 octaves and over 2 years got them back. So singing means a lot to people, different things. So I find working on people's voices is a privilege because I try to come from the point of view that they are all capable of brilliance and it's my job to find it, while at the same time reassuring them that whatever comes out of their mouth is great or okay, and to encourage failure. You know, just like, you know, crack, who cares? You know, you might lead to something great. I've learned more teaching than I have studying, really. And also you have to put your money where your mouth is. If I'm saying to you, don't have any fear, breathe, relax, just be you. I have to do that too, you know? But I'd been at the COC for many years with their after-school opera program, create an opera in an hour program in classrooms. And I said, why don't we do this? Why don't we teach kids to create their own? So Gleesicle was born of that, where they create their own musical from scratch. You start in a room with literally just a piano and a whole lot of kids. And then at the end of the year, they create their own show. And each child gets heard in a solo. There's a point where we stagnate, or some people feel like their ideas aren't being heard, or others feel like they don't like the direction the process is going in, or they're shy to speak with each other because one person they feel is stronger, more dominant than others. So it's a really great forum for us to hash out human issues, you know, of working together. Because the voice is the audible projection of the soul. The voice is an expression of who the person is, what their values are, what their emotional state is, where their breath center is, how they're feeling that day, what they think of themselves, what they think of others. So when you're working on that, it's very sensitive. You can't blame the instrument, you know. I think my journey as a singer and a teacher has been to make it simple. And the way to really pull people into music and pull into singing with confidence is intention, because it releases the breath. And that's the moment in workshops where I find singers, people who are non-singers or identify as, you know, I'd rather die than sing in public, surprise themselves.